The European Central Bank slashed its interest rates by 25 basis points to 3.5% as expected. This is the second rate cut this year for the ECB, which began its easing in June. The bank says it is now appropriate to take another step in moderating the degree of monetary policy restriction based on the Governing Council's updated assessment of the inflation outlook. The ECB sees inflation declining towards its 2% target over the second half of next year. All eyes are now turned to the commentary of ECB President Christine Lagarde on whether additional rate cuts are on the horizon for October and December. Next week, it will be the Federal Reserve's turn, with the U.S. Central Bank expected to begin policy easing.
Lego teams up McLaren to build a replica of the McLaren P1 supercar. British Formula One star Lando Norris got to test drive the race car at the Silverstone Circuit in the UK. The life-size replica features over 342,000 Lego bricks and an electric motor. It took 23 Lego Group and McLaren Automotive specialists a total of 8,344 hours to build the race car. It's a Danish toymaker's first scale build that is able to turn corners and complete an entire race circuit lap. Asian markets ended Thursday trade higher as tech stocks got a boost from Wall Street's rally overnight. Japan's Nikkei 225 and the South Korean KOSPI both jumped more than 2%. Philippine shares joined the rally, with the main index finally closing above the 7,000 level for the first time in 19 months.
It's a good sign, no, that we pierced through the 7,000 finally. No, so far the 7,000 area is really proving to be a strong resistance, no, for the PSEI. From the chart, though, is lack of confluence. Okay. That would tell me that the market really has already run its course, no? Except, of course, no, the long upper shadow candle it made on Tuesday, no? Because normally we can see from the daily or hourly chart, no, signs of being overbought, no? Most of the time we see bearish divergences, no? Especially on the hourly chart, no, preceding a correction. But for now, the index, I think, is still on the fighting mode.
In notable stock movement in the region, 7&I shares surged 4.5% Thursday after Bloomberg reported Canada's Alimentation Couche-Tard is considering raising its $38.5 billion offer price to buy the 7-Eleven operator. The Asian Development Bank launches a six-year partnership with the Philippines geared towards helping the country advance its development agenda. The 2024 to 2029 country partnership strategy aims to support the Philippines in developing its economic competitiveness, quality infrastructure, as well as nature-based development. The projects that will be supported by this partnership include the Bataan-Cavite Interlink Bridge and the North-South Commuter Railway. The ADB is the Philippines' leading multilateral development partner and the second largest source of official development assistance. NEDA says the ADB has made a total net commitment of 8.8 billion pesos to support Philippine development projects.
Picture an economy growing at 6% annually, over 6% annually, where growth translates into real benefits for everyday Filipinos. Imagine smoother commutes that give you back precious hours, schools that open doors to opportunities for children, and a healthcare system that ensures that every family can access the care that they need. This strategy is about turning lofty goals such as those into tangible improvements in the daily lives of our people. Today, we are not just talking about progress. We are delivering it with clear, impactful actions.